European Union following the crash in Ethiopia at the weekend. A pair of Turkish Airlines services to Gatwick and Birmingham had to return to Istanbul mid-flight. In sport, Manchester City are just kicking off their Champions League last 16 second leg tie with Schalke, holding a 3-2 lead from the first match. Aberdeen have taken an early 1-0 advantage in their Scottish Cup quarter-final replay with Rangers, and it's currently goalless between Hearts and Partick Thistle. That's the latest. I'm Laura Safe.
This is WFM 97.2.
Withenshaw FM is sponsored by Withenshaw Community Housing Trust, the Withenshaw Forum and the Forum Library. We would like to thank our sponsors, partners and advertisers for supporting our voluntary radio station.
Hello, I'm Ros Johnson and I'm asking you out to lunch on Thursday. It won't cost you anything and you can expect quite a variety on the menu. Several courses of music and a bit of this and a bit of that. Could be some snippets gleaned from predictive text or letters in the press. Maybe a little brain stretching too. So, I look forward to your company on Thursday between 12 and 2 on Withenshaw FM 97.2.
Just hold on. Okay, hold on. Right. Okay. Mr. Steve Kekana. I'm all right. And how are you, Mr. Steve Kekana? Welcome to the program.
I'm very fine. I pass my greetings to all your listeners.
They love you so much, you know that.
So I hear.
Mr. Steve Kekana, I'm a Dubai with Tanda Kakulu. Oh, God, I'm going to go to Umabi Yeleka Kulu about Tanda Kakulu.
Please receive my heartfelt greetings to all the listeners of the station in London and England. We love you here down south, and I hope God will treat you fine.
Mr. Steve Kekana wakhuluma isilungu kangaka, usikhupha usithatha ngapha isilungu esinje?
Well, it's because I did attend school. I attended school up to high university level.
I surrender. Ukuthi wona kulomuntu okhuluma isilungu esinje isikhiwe esinje e-Africa.
Yeah, but many people do speak English here in South Africa.
Right, for those who are joining us, my name is A. Marshall Command. How are you folks in all parts of the world? Ihamba lobaba uSteve Kekana. Abaningi liyamazi kakhulu. Walihlabela ingoma ethi usafila. Walitshayela ingoma then ethi yizwanini yizwanini. Alike libambe njalo. Bamba njalo Steve Kekana. Well done, Steve Kekana. Sike tshaya ingoma yakhe emnandi okwamagama, Steve Kekana. Color me white, color me black.
Well, when we recorded this song, it was the time, the period of the middle of apartheid. And, you know, the black and white were actually not allowed to be seen together. But and we had to write this song with my producer Tony Lomai and Malcolm Watson. Malcolm Watson was like a guy. And then we had to tell the nation that it doesn't matter. Even if you can color me black, color me white, it's love that makes the world go round. Trying to restrict or prohibit the staying together of black and white won't stop love, and love is the one that makes the world go round.
But what's my apartheid, Mr. Steve Kekana? How was the apartheid?
I can simply put it, apartheid was a mental sickness. Because somebody who could come and think that the creation of God can be easily separated just like that is not very normal. It was like a sickness to me. Maybe it, I don't want to say those people who created apartheid were sick mentally, but they were, I would rather say, selfish and did not have the love of humanity within themselves. That's why I compare it with madness.
Mm. kwaphela abantu ye-apartheid kwakuluyo Mr. Steve Gekana ngoba just usitele nje I know what it has got nothing to do with in music but it would be nice to hear from our father a man who grew up by the time bekuluyiwa lapho labelungu
It was that is why organizations like the ANC and PAC had to go outside to try and wage war against the white minority regime. It was not a fully blown up war. It was like, for lack of a better word, it was a matter of people planning to destroy installations of the government, make the country ungovernable. It wasn't such a big all-out war, but the actions of the freedom fighters really explained that the nation is not happy about apartheid. And the boycotts that followed, the whole world boycotting South Africa and everything from sports and even music. But then it made the government understand that no, we cannot go on forever with this madness.
Mm. So do you think ukuphuma kaNelson Mandela from prison helped a lot, ain't
it? It was a very big blessing. It was a gift that South Africa will never ever forget. When he came back, many people thought that he was going to come out with vengeance, wanting to revenge and everything. He surprised most of us. Then he said, no, now let's talk with these very people who were not regarding black people as equal citizens of the country. He surprised most of us.
Nelson Mandela brought independence impijana abantu bangani bayaqalisa ukuzwanana ukuthi hayi lo mhlophe lo muntu singabantu bani
Yes, he actually if you don't believe in miracles then you would not believe that Nelson Mandela was present and he came out and preached peace
Mr. Kekana, the only thing is every time when I come to South Africa, you run away from me by and tell about to be lapa, obonakale lapa, obonakale lapa. It's not I'm not accusing you. You run away, and I know. But right, let's go now. What's Steve Kekana? Evele ezalelwa kuphi?
I was born on the 16th of September 1958 in a place called Zebediela. In the northern part of South Africa, in what we call Limpopo province now. So I was born there, sighted, and then by the age of 5, I was attacked by glaucoma, which took away most of my eyesight. I had to go and study in senior school for the blind until I made my standard 10, which is an entry level to university. I did not go straight away to university because I was born from a very poor family. And so I had to, fortunately, be called by a certain schoolmate of mine called Lazarus. Then we formed an amateur group. That's where I was met by Tom Yim, who happens to be my producer. And then he took me to Joburg in 1978. That's where I started recording professionally, and since then I never looked back. But and I'm still in mission even now. I then decided to fulfill my long time dream of being you call it a barrister there in England. So I went to university and studied law. As I'm speaking to you, I have 3 law degrees, Juris, LLB, and Masters in Labor Law. But I think I'm no longer going to practice law very much. I'm getting old now. I'm on a pensioner now at 60.
You are not, don't ever bring that to us. You are not. You are a spring chicken. We all know that you are a spring chicken. Tell us, we want to know the life of Steve Kekana. Abantu, they are waiting and they are enjoying. They are enjoying. They want to know the history of Steve Kekana. So, before you go further, you said you were transferred to a school. Were you born blind or you were born a guy?
No, I was sighted up to the age of 5, where I was attacked by an eye sickness called glaucoma. You see?
Yay!
It took a lot of my eyesight. That's where I went to study at a senior school for the blind.
Right, Steve Kekana, there. When you left your school or where you is going to a school of blind, how did people how were they treating you, especially your friends, your relatives? I bet some of people they started treating you very badly.
I think people were just scared of disabled people. You know, in my village, disabled people were a scarcity. So For them to get acclimatized and get used to living with me and playing with me being blind, it was like an awful hell of a task. So they, I wouldn't really, you know, when I grew up, I thought they were treating me bad. But now that I'm a bit grown up, I understand that it was sheer fear. They were just scared of the unknown. But at the same time, somehow I found myself deserted.
Mr. Kekan.
Uh-huh.
You know, I read about Impilo Yako, so I read about your life. I did an interview with you before, but you know, in every show I do, I've got new people, you know. Your story, you know, is interesting to us, for, you know, we are abakhulayo, abafana abakhulayo, but, you know, there are some people who never believe, you know, so, you know, when you told me about when you moved to another school, it pained me a lot. So, then you finished your school, and then how did they start receiving you when you finished your school?
No, when they started hearing my music being played over the radio, they started accepting me. Even chicks, even girls started being amenable. So, you know, I was then accepted. Because then they saw me, I was able to buy my first car, I had a driver, I built my mom a better house than what I grew in, and you know, people started realizing that the man is as equal as we are, maybe even better than we are as sighted people. So the music made me acceptable to mine.
Right, your first album. Because I grew up listening to my album, and I'm like, Izwanini, Ushabela, Steve Kekana. Which one was your first album with Baleni?
Well, my first album was named Mumsy. It was done in March 1978.
Yeah, Mbakanga leyo.
I don't think it was Mbakanga that much. It was like, you know, the Donna Summer kind of rhythm?
Yeah.
Zulu. Sung in Zulu, you know, it was... When we did that thing, we thought we were doing disco music, you know, but gradually these descended into the Mpanganga Sulu, and then on and on we went.
Right, Baba Jano Steve Kekana, Dangwan has a kumike verse song. Just hold on, guessing that any Gomaka Steve Kekana, Ingomemna Jogamakama, just hold on, Steve Kekana. Right, Mumsala Zoba, Mumsala Zoe, enjoy with this AFM 97.2. Hold on, Steve. Right, Steve Kekana, Ingomemna Jogamakama, right. Right, why boy? So, how did you get as a music? So, did someone pull you with you when I was your music? How did you start with that?
No, at
senior
school, the authorities they bought us some music instruments, so we taught each other to play this instrument. So, I started singing from an early age. At school, I was already singing. So after my standard 10, then me and my fellow student, former student, he's so resting to be late now, Lazarus Hoffman, that's when we formed an amateur group called Hunters. That's when I started. Singing has been my life from early stages. As if I have to pray to the late Oliver Mtukudzi, he said, I'm sure I started singing from the first second that I was born. When I cried, they thought I was crying, maybe I was singing. They could not just understand the song.
Yeah, my child. I remember those legends. May you so rest in peace. Yes, I cannot say hello to all of you. There are so many people who are listening to this program. We are driving with the Air Marshal Commander and the legend, Steve Kekana. Right, Steve Kekana, Kabambe Kanjalo. Right, Mr. Steve Kekana, right. Why pala ke air kanisa kuduma yipi ke kuma album akho because ukanise very early. What was ama 80s?
Ngikanise ngo
1978, Steve Kekana ekanisa ezokuhlabela.
Professionally, then I started. Umam sold over 25,000 copies within 2 weeks.
Yay!
But that was the beginning, and I never looked back. I sing in more than three languages. I sing Zulu, I sing Shangwan, I sing Soto, I sing English. So, and that's why the one that you just played, Gloria, it's a Roman Catholic hymn for Christmas. We don't, in my church, we don't sing that song at this time. It's Lent now. Where Jesus went into the wilderness for 40 days. So we don't sing Gloria during this 40 days. We sing songs of sorrow, remembering the 40 days of Jesus Christ. I'm a Roman Catholic. Don't think I don't go to church. Yeah.
Right. Uizwanini. Iphumelele. Uthi album so izwanini ngithi is the album izwanini.
Yes, izwanini was recorded in 1980. Yeah, was in 1980. Let me remember.
It was in 1997.
Yeah.
Yabudlisa njalo izwanini, especially abafana base Zimbabwe.
They love it. They, I thought they would love
Oh my way, Africa! Yahla tena, why palelo mbano my ulokuze ni my way nika Africa. Umfana wase Zimbabwe.
When I wrote the song, I remember I was sitting in a hotel at the Ohio, and I had a friend next to me. I said, listen, I want to sing this song. I've written a song that I want to sing it in Shona. So he helped me with the writing of the Shona words. And the pronunciation, I hope I did pronounce them well. And yeah, so I always called Boulevard my second home from home. As I'm speaking to you, I'm in my house in the Mediola. I've named it the Boulevard Palace.
Yay! Why Palela Umfana wa Kumbula? I know Umfana wa Kumbula wa Palela my way. What is the name of the song?
Which one? The
Nigaye Azania, what is the name?
I can't remember. I want to be honest, I can't remember the real name.
Do you know why he actually wrote that song? Because they thought that Umandela wathengisa ilizwe ebalungwini. That's why he said kona why bangabe city you call why city ayibuye ilizwe le South Africa kanibuye ebantwini abamnyama.
Yeah.
Steve Gekala, so right you want Palama album abamanga you wonke in total.
The album are 45 in total. The last one I've just released end of last year, and it's called Ubuntu. It's a very beautiful song. It's even in the iTunes and all that. You can find it if you want to.
Fantastic, Steve Kekana. Right, I've got a surprise for you. Right, let's see if I can do this surprise for you. Oh, just hold on. Steve Kekana. Hey, Johnny, see what Bonnie's on, so Mr. Steve Kekana.
In Zimbabwe was a beautiful country.
Yeah.
And that's why I used to call it my second home from home. By then it has not deteriorated to what it has deteriorated to be.
Yeah.
It was a lovely country, and I want to believe that it will be able to come back to where it was before.
Oliver Mtukudzi, the baguette, rest in peace, your friend Oliver Mtukudzi.
Oliver Mtukudzi was the best friend in Zimbabwe. When I came to Zimbabwe in 1980 for the first time, he was the only musician of Zimbabwe who came to visit me in my hotel. Then after that, we started meeting other musicians. And my friend that I saw first was Oliver Mtukudzi. And I even played his song on stage. You know, Chimsoro?
Wanyanya, Chimsoro, aye, Chimsoro.
Yeah, I know for you, some new people say, okay, I can't put you here.
He was a nice man, Oliver Mtukudzi. He was a very nice man. I remember when I did an interview with you, you told me about Oliver Mtukudzi. You did tell me.
The last show I played with Oliver Mtukudzi was last year on the 15th of December. That was the last show we played together in South Africa.
You know what? Honest enough, you know, impilo, Mr. Steve Kekana, it's life. What can you do? It's life. Yes. So Mr. Steve Kekana, uhamba, indawo osozibhodile wa usuka uchaya kwa Zimbabwe, uchayile kakhulu eZimbabwe.
I did perform in Zimbabwe. I performed in Malawi, I performed in Zambia, I performed in Mozambique, Lesotho, Swaziland, and Botswana. They are my homes, those ones.
Those are your homes.
We perform in England, we perform in Holland, in Scandinavian countries, and we perform in LA. Yes, quite a lot of countries I did visit.
Just hold on, I want to remind you of your friend. Hold on. My father, Steve Kekana, why China Pella, Steve Kekana, Oliver Mtukudzi, James Soro, Wanyanya, we are talking about Steve Kekana. Right, Steve Kekana.
I love that song.
You love that song, Steve Kekana. When Oliver Mtukudzi passed away, the first person I thought was you, because you told me about Oliver Mtukudzi. You did on our first interview.
Yes, and I'm not going to change. He remains a friend even in his life.
That's great. So, right, ama album manje lapha sesingena. I know what you will never remember all your albums, and it's not good for you not to forget your albums. It's not nice, Daddy.
Well, maybe it's good to forget some of them, because it gives you an opportunity of writing new songs. Remember in the past, then it means I won't write new songs.
I always do my best to promote this gentleman. I love this man. I grew up listening to this music. Listen to this.
Yeah, What's it on?
The issue which is there is this thing which is slowly creeping into the country and they call it nice time. You know, the youth of the country don't sleep now, they go to nightclubs and they go there and they indulge in alcohol. And when they're done with alcohol, they fight amongst each other. They come home injured, and then some have to be pushed home through wheelbarrows and all that. Then I'm suing against such acts. I said, this is not right, not bad, it must be discouraged. It's bad, it must be discouraged.
What's the Kakana? I'm not sure if I'm going to lose. Oh, shit. I'm going to lose.
Yeah, you know, this hymn in Sotho and in Zulu, we're not using same lyrics. In Sotho, because my father was a church leader, so he told me that this song in Sotho, the words that we use in Sotho were written by the snake when Noah built an ark. And the snake was seeing everything being swallowed by the water and everything. The snake was standing there saying, this is a real miracle that God also loves me. Even though people are saying I'm a bad thing, I'm just a serpent, but the God still wanted me to be saved. That's what it says in Sotho.
That's what it says in Sotho. Yes, yeah, but my was with is the legend still alive? Yes, he's still alive and kicking. I've got so many people. I've got Leonard Kavana, I've got Golizit, I've got so many people. Phineas Emoroiwa. I cannot mention you all, guys. Forgive me, guys. Otherwise, please, yes, it is Steve Kekana. Yes, I always tell you that this is my father. When I go to South Africa, I'll look for him this time. Whether or not, I'll look for you, Mr. Steve Kekana.
Yeah, tell me when you come. Tell me in good time. Why, if you want me to have an interview over the radio, you are not running away. It means you are not telling me when you are coming.
I love you, Stevie. I really love you, Steve Kekana. Right?
It's a surprise, and then you end up surprising yourself. So,
end up surprising myself.
Yeah. Well, you don't take me by surprise. Tell me that I'll be in South Africa and I would love to meet you. Then we will arrange with you. So you will meet me.
Thank you very much. Who's Steve Kekana? Yes, I know what this guy is saying. And he says, if you're a mongo, you're in South Africa. Right, Steve Kekana. Ingoma Oti. Yeah. Usakalisa, when you were starting, yangu paramisa. Usa, you know, when you're starting, yangu paramisa, sibili, yangu paramisa, wangani. Which one was your first album? What, yeah, that person bonuti, that person yung Steve Kekana, sibili, or Amakunis?
The song that really made me great, the song Ipupo.
Ipupo?
Ipupo that made me a big man in South Africa, I must tell you. And then followed others like Take Your Love and Keep It, but Ipupo was the one that lifted me up.
Yeah, right. Yatengwa, indawo zonke, wakalisa kuthi, na ishuwa senyu Steve Kekana lapha lami, sembonakala.
Yeah, no, it made me a real big fan here in South Africa, that song, Ipupo. It was loved all over. Whether Sotho speaking or Zulu speaking, it was just loved the same way.
I
ipopo liyana ti nandi ipopo engili pupe izolo selo kwe ngabayimi angase mpupe kanjena ngipupe ngidajukelwe ngesicathulo sibhokokile. I see you.
Yeah, that's the one. When we need to take you into the studio and we re-record it and do it with it.
Advocate and a lawyer?
A lawyer is the one who serves at the magistrate court and all that. But the advocate is the one who goes to the high courts.
Right, okay, the advocate goes to the high court now. Very good, my very good. Thank you for, you know, that thing. Even Shuba Kakulu, lawyer, advocate, lawyer, everyone is now an advocate.
Yeah, a lawyer here in South Africa only goes to the lower court. If a lawyer goes to the high court, he has to brief an advocate, and then he can go to the high court with that lawyer. Yes.
Fantastic, Steve Kekana. Yes, guys, honest enough, I have never seen so many emails. Honest enough, I don't want to lie to you. This is unbelievable. That's why I love you so much, you guys. Your support you are giving me is just unbelievable. Mr. Mm-hmm. Steve Kekana said, are you still producing music now?
Yes, I still produce. I have just finished and produced my 35th album. End of last year, in November, it was released. It's called Ubuntu, and it's a beautiful song. It's a beautiful album. People are going to love it.
So, if I can ask...
It's on all social media platforms. You can find it.
Since you have got your lovely son who lives in England, is he going to get one CD?
Yeah, you call me, then you send me your address, you'll find it.
I love you, Daddy. I really love you. I will always love you, Steve Kekana. You just make me, you know, I'm so proud. I've never, ever, whenever I give you a call, you have never ignored my calls. You always say you are welcome, and I'm so proud. And listeners, Steve Kekana has got a new album. Is it Lebis or Idokisa Pewa?
No, it's done. It's on sale now. They can buy it on iTunes. who can guide on all record stores. But yeah, I'm sure there in England you'll have to use the iTunes.
The album is called Ubuntu.
Ubuntu, yes.
Right, all of us said, Ubuntu Steve, can call us your album, and Ja Octown, Ubuntu, Yatolaga, my iTunes, since I can't get Utikona, any Robo Spotify, and other places, all tens of music, but it is a lot of Sikona. So, Steve, can call our album, and Jam support, and Yazo, and Yam support, and Yazo, Banke, Abala, and Bami Bam support, Steve Kekana. Steve Kekana, Sikatisa, what do you want to tell your listeners who have been always by you, who always loves you, who always, what is your message to your listeners?
My message is to my listeners, try by all means to be humble. Do not praise yourself, let others do so. Your praises must not come out from your mouth or lips. Let your praises come from your fellow citizens. Then you will find yourself being a better person on earth.
Right, Steve Kekana. Baba kanjalo Steve Kekana, singa kawuvalelisi, sike sithi kamanje. Ngiyakwesaba we malume, ngenkosi kazi yakho, ngiyakwesaba we malume.
That's exactly what I was saying. You know, people who like gossiping about other people, they cause trouble in families, they cause trouble in the nation. So such people I'm scared of, you know, gossipers.
Fantastic. Namhlanje was one tjela the reason of that song. Abantu bayasala besithi uSteve Kekana ngaphuma mathi umbonile. Umbonile uSteve Kekana lapha.
You see, such people are dangerous. They cause havoc in families, they cause havoc in the world. And that needs to be discouraged. It should not be allowed to go on unadmonished.
Right, Mr. Kekana, do you have any regrets in life?
Well, yes, I think I do have some regrets. The greatest regret that I always think of is that...
Credit remaining, 71 pence. Right, the number you wish to dial.
Number yethu kababa Steve Kekana isiqumekile laphana kungasenani. Ngizamtshela ukuthi hayi inamba yethu iqumekile. Right, no problem.
I'm not
Right. Let's just wait for the news. Then after the news, I'll be crossing over to Sky for the news just in a few minutes. Right, while we are waiting for the news. Steve Kekana Zokari. FM 97.2.
On the Sky News Centre at 9, MPs have overwhelmingly rejected Theresa May's Brexit deal for a second time. A majority of 149 voted against the Prime Minister's plan. Senior Tory backbencher Sir Graham Brady says he was surprised by how big the rejection was.
If this vote was going to be a success, then the Democratic Unionists had to be behind it. We also had to see that the Attorney General's advice was really unequivocal.
It means there'll be another vote in Parliament tomorrow asking MPs whether they're willing to leave the EU without a deal on March the 29th. Democratic Unionist MP Nigel Dodds is clear how they'll be voting.
The best way to get a deal that you can actually vote for is to keep the threat of a no deal on the table. Once you take that threat off, you're bound to be offered terms which are less advantageous, in the sure and certain knowledge that the other side have, that you're not going to walk away.
Three people have died after a crash involving two cars and a bus in Aberdeenshire. Four people were also injured in the collision on the A90 between Aberdeen and Dundee. An avalanche on Ben Nevis has killed three climbers. A fourth's been rescued from the UK's highest mountain and taken to hospital. The EU Aviation Safety Watchdog is banning all flights across Europe by a model of plane that crashed in Ethiopia. The Boeing 737 MAX 8 and 9 jets are suspended. In sport, Manchester City are looking to become the third English side to reach the Champions League quarterfinals. Adam Jury is watching their match with Schalke.
Man City lead Schalke on the night by 3-0, and with a 6-2 aggregate lead have this tie all sewn up. The deadlock was broken in the 35th minute when Sergio Aguero scored from the spot. 3 minutes later, Aguero poked the ball home for his second. Then Leroy Sané's low finish made it 3 to all but secure City's passage into the Champions League last night. Half-time at the Etihad, it's Man City 3, Schalke 0.
Aberdeen are beating Rangers 1-0 in their Scottish Cup quarter-final replay. Hearts have come from behind to lead Partick Thistle 2-1. That's the latest. I'm Laura Safe.
This is WFM 97.2.
Withenshaw Forum, your social, leisure and business hub.
Forum opportunities.
Announcing the Forum's brand new employment and training partnership comprising Job Centre Plus and Manchester Adult Education to get the best advice, good quality training and real-time updates on jobs.
Read, research, join a group, get IT support and access council services at Forum Library. See a GP, attend a clinic, get medical advice from Forum Health. Avoid the queues, use Forum Pharmacy for
express.
Get an active lifestyle at Forum Leisure.
Healthy living.
Check out great childcare at Forum Nursery.
Yeah, we're Philip, a Marshall Commander.
At Forum Hall, or book for your private function. Join in with
kids
throughout the year.
Enjoy.
The fabulous Forum.
Yeah, sorry. Are you ready now? Sorry, you need to delay my system, but I'm ready for you now.
Remember all the music? Yes, the TV shows. What was on in the cinema?
Pardon?
Every Friday, 4 till 5 p.m. on the 70s Char Show.
Okay, because if you want, we can do 10 minutes. I'll make it quick for you. All right, just hold on, Sissy, hold on.
Mm-hmm.
manje manje kunjani?
Ngiyaphila kanjani?
Ay uzosixolela abantu bakumelele lapha sisi akuthi cup cup ubuyelela abalaleli. I know ukuthi it's a bit late but asiphoke ukuthi cup cup ukwenzela ukuthi abantu kade siba promisele bakwazi bayakuthanda kakhulu babingelele. Yeah, bakuzwa kahle ukuthi bakhuluma lo sisi wethu othandekayo kakhulu ubatshela ukuthi isiqabhobho lesi esihle kangakambani.
Ngikhuluma no-40 osalanda i-symptom zesimanjemanje.
Ulokhu usajibilika yini?
Ayo.
Ngithi ulokhu usakwazi ukugida na?
Bazobona into abangazange bayibone.
Bazobona into abangazange bayibone. Uniqalelile ukuhlabela laqala njani? How did you start ukuhlabela?
Ngisaqala 1960.
Ama 1960s?
Yebo, 1960 nabantu.
Yay!
And then, Saham, Nisada, and Nasir Zimbabwe, Namibia, Botswana, Nasuna Research.
Beni Chibiliga, you have a Chibiliga, you're in town.
Wow, that's why I want this done.
I hope I'm begun challenge when you was rooting on a song late, but I hope I'm begun challenge by your bubbles. Bekuthiwoni likhuluma ukulahla komntwana esaphila.
Asaphila kakhulu ngokuthi khona isisiyetini organization okuthiwa abomama besiqaqa la ukhona khona i-Esma Hotela Community, John Muriri namanye amaqembu abaningi.
So nalitshaya labo ema hotela Queens uma hlathini lahlabela naye.
Ka i-Esma Hotela Queens laba
Okay. La hamba libhodile umhlaba lingena eZimbabwe. Yey madoda, so ngubani obebhala ingoma ezimnandi kangaka? Ngubani obezibhala zonke ingoma lezi? Ngubani okade eyi-leader? Yey madoda, are you still lokho lisasekhona lonke? Lokho lisasekhona kumbe abanye sebatshona?
Ulungiwe washona zarati zisasekhona sakhilaisasekunelendlela leminzi.
But I come to South Africa ngiyalidinga liyambalekela ngibuye South Africa ngiyalidinga liyambalekela why limbalekela
ka noma nje ngoba usenza ngabi loyo ukhona nesithola khona nje khona sathi
lokho lisachaya lokho lisachaya kodwa lokho lisa say that again ma'am. I'm coming to see you.
Yeah,
but you might have a lot of email, a bank, and my email, which I'm going to eat them self manje manje. Right, I'm an album, Lisa was with Lamanga, and Tempo Nicomas and his Nanga cool.
I'm 25.
UK lapha okulomqando emqandweni liyabuya
bathi lebu
lizobuya sibili lizochaya
bathi yebo bathi nabasibile lebangebona
ningadinga ama organizers liyabuya sibili ligadi ndizamthina libuye lizochaya estejini
bathi bayimthe manje ngabe bonke bangakwazi bayibona isiphathe ukudlula kuqala.
Bekunjani khona South Africa? How was South Africa in general?
South Africa, no right, uthi nje isupport kakhulu ayisekho. Manje ibathe ibhekele music yabo leyo R&B leyo abasakhula basenanda banawo kodwa khona labo nangabo abasasilandela.
Manje mina mfuna ukubuya ngizobona omagogo ngiyenze lami album yami ngichaye album yami lani khona phana ngibe yilead guitar la livumela ngasemuva.
Yebo
nikhuluma lentombi yasimanje manje yakutshela wena upetolela uyaphaka ubulala lawo bantombazana. Right, so okwamanje nxa abantu belidinga nyakwazi ukuthi eZimbabwe balidinga kakhulu litholakala kuphi?
Ubabukiliki njengoba asiorganizelele interview ngakho nje ngingathi abafunayo nabaxhumane naye and yena uzokhuluma nabo izinto zonke masizokuzakuyona.
Very good. I want to talk to ama promoters laphana maye sike siorganize ukuthi kona engxenye landile ngabuya lapha like lizochawa ngomoya kancane ngase England. Kukho kuyini ofuna ukutshela abalaleli ungakahambi? I know that you busy. I am sorry for coming for bringing you late. But what do you want to tell our listeners akho abavele bakhula bekuthanda abakusanda ukuthanda lana namhlanje? What do you want to say to them? I love you guys, I really love you. Right, abafuna ukuthenga ingoma zenu zitholakala kuphi ingoma zenu?
Okwamanje bazithola ku YouTube zonke nami nomsindo nayo uyazithola ku YouTube.
How many are you in the group? Libangaki ku group?
Oh, ikhosini? Yeah. If the planning is 2x5, or the econ 2x4.
Labor 4. Very good, very good. Nine. Right. What do you want to tell? Ufuna ukutshelana abalaleli bakho uba akubanikeze amazwi amnandi abalaleli bakho bafuna ukukwazi ukuthi hayi nxa belidinga akubatshela ukuthi kona vele litholakala kanjani oyiweb got any words you want to tell abalaleli bakho.
Into engabatshela yona ukuthi nabalele lakhona kuyithi
Credit remaining.
Isikhathile lapha ifoni yakhe angikwazi ukuthi kwenzakala laphana. Ye, hayi ngomsakazi wabantu abantu intombi zesimanje manje. Coming up, I'll be talking to Owen and Toby. Boy from Zimbabwe, he has done it with a new CD. My little boy from Bedbridge, Mark G. My little boy from Zimbabwe, Mark G. Support this young boy of mine. We support our local talent.
Commander Philips Fund, how are you, sir?
I'm doing very fine. You have just done as if you are the one, Oil Marshal Commander, because the way you have just spoke.
I'm sounding like the original Air Marshal Commander. Why you stamp the photocopy of the original?
You have got no chance to be a photocopy of me. You won't get close to the boy. Right, when him Toby, we are the number and then father was still to win him Toby Band. Right, Oyin Mthobi, udume ngani waziwa ngani abantu abaningi sebo ubona lapha Oyin Mthobi. What is Oyin Mthobi?
Alright, Oyin Mthobi is a non-fiction author. Ngabhala ibhuku le non-fiction titled The Power, Anger, Over Joy. A book that deals with sociological and philosophical understandings of society and its behaviors.
Right. Always what about the book? How old are you, Van?
I'm 23 years old. I'm turning 23 on 18 March.
Right, your birthday is close to mine, but forget about birthday because you end up asking me for presents. Right, let's go to the book. Ubala ibhuku ubusikubu khuluma ngani laqala le book.
Yes, it's my first ever book ukuthi ngilibhale. Ngangikhuluma ngendaba zamandla, the power anger over joy, ukuthi amandla siwazisa njani njengabantu, ukuthi amandla siwazisa njengokuthi umuntu osemandleni, the person who is in power. We believe is that person who holds a public post, but the he who holds a public post is not necessarily powerful, but is a servant of the society. A public post is only a token of appreciation from the people, not something that elevates someone to be powerful. It only elevates someone to be the servant of the people.
Why do you already sound like a politician? Anyway, forget about being a politician because you already sounding like one. Right, amabhukwako awuso ayatholakala ngapha amabhukwako.
Amabhuku ayatholakala ku Amazon, abafisa ukuthola amabhuku ami ibhula, they can go ku Amazon, basethi bathi the power, comma, anger over joy, the power, comma, anger over joy, bazalithola on Amazon. Nxa befuna bangithinta ku Facebook page yami Oyin Mthobi or ku Twitter yengi yami Mthobi.
As continue, kanjalo mfana. So right, I was making a trailer of your book. What are you talking in your book? Jago a trailer, bichan.
All right. Basically, the typesetting. The typesetting is that kule segment Dr. Ama Arrows and Paradigms is a segment. Lapho kwalisa kona ibe lama poems and short things, short words. Intelligent words are kuluma about what is to be preempted later in the book. And Malikalis again go by chapter one on Kona. I place a fact after naming a fact, then I went out a historical interpretation of that fact. And then, at the end of the day, I find an image that is either a proverb or wise words that are in society that have been adopted by society to prove that whatever I am writing exists in the society doesn't exist in my own big skull.
Yay, madoda, in your own skull. We are using Oyin.
Ngiyakukhulu, ngiyakuzwa kakhulu Emyself Commander. Basically, yilimenza libhuku langikhona, so ngiyabe ngikhuluma ngendaba zamandla, ukuthi abantu amandla sikubona amandla siwabona influence, amandla siwabona influence ukuthi umuntu yenelise ukubana ahuge abantu abaningi ukuthi bamlandele, kodwa abantu kabalandeli kungalasizathu, abantu balandelela isizathu umuntu, isizathu singaphela umuntu kasalandelwa, isizathu esenza umuntu alandele yini, isizathu esenza umuntu alandele ukuthi lo amlandelayo uza kwenelisa ukubana asatisfy ama-needs and wants akhe. So influence is of need origination, hence need are the powerful element in the equation of power. Ipower ngendlela thina esiyizwisisa ngayo, but then the book goes further and explains what raw power is, and in its quest to explain what raw power is, it expresses power as an individualistic form, an individualistic ability, something that comes from the inside to the outside, something that comes, that manifests itself to the outside, but originating from the content of one's personality.
Right, how much is your book?
My book is selling at least $10. $10 for those who have US dollars, $35 $35 if you are this side. Then on the Kingu version on Amazon is only $8.99.
Fantastic, fantastic. So if someone wants to buy your book, SMS, we am to mail, how do you do it?
Umuntu nxa ufuna ukuthenga ibhuku in Europe, he or she will contact Zeti Dube. Zeti Dube is the guy who runs the logistics in Europe.
Fantastic, fantastic. Umthobi lapha umfana ukuthi ngoyini Umthobi, umfana obhala ibhuku madoda limsupport limsekele kakhulu. Mfana, wena ingoma uthanda ingoma ezinjani?
Mina ngiyithanda i-country music, but ngoba lolu luhlelo lwesintwini, mina ngithanda ukuthinxa ngizacela ungihlalele ubheke umuzi ethi ake sikhulumeni le ndaba uyangixaka, ake sikhulumeni le ndaba uyandida kuhulumente, ake sikhulume le ndaba uyangixaka.
Awumfana nami u-Oyeni Mthobi, right u-Oyeni Mthobi, ngamafithane nje ngunika nje few minutes ukuthi khona ukhuluma ufuna ukukhuluma. What do you want to say to your people abafuna ibhuku lakho? What khaphukhapu ngamafithane ayakusela airtime?
Okay, engizafuna ukukutshela nje abantu ukubana nxa bebala ibhuku bazame ukuthi babale every word with a mind that is deep in superiority so that they can get the larger picture that I was trying to paint, because I was painting a picture in the social trenches.
Uthe ubheke umuzi ngoma ethini?
Ngifuna ukuze ingoma ethi ake sikhulumeni, ubheke umuzi luthuli i-album ka-1818, ake sikhulumeni.
But how can you know ubheke umuzi luthuli at your age?
Mina emashawu commander ngilalela ingoma zabantu abadala ngoba yizo lapho ezingenza ngizwisise kakhulu impilo ngendlela.
The credit on your card is
right, i-credit yethu sisithi bitana mfana, what khaphukhaphu ke i-credit yethu sintutshane, what khaphukhaphu credits? Uyangizwa Owen?
Hayi, angenza, I didn't get that.
Qedisa yethu i-credit yethu siphelile mfana, what khaphukhaphu?
Alright, that is ngisithi yiyo ingoma engizacela ukuthi ngidlalele na kuphela. I think mina offside, rest my case, Marshall Commander.
Okay, my friend, I always promote you. I love you so much. Oh, and you told him now, I love you. I'll see you in July.
Thank you.
Okay, oh, and you told him, Fana, I'm also cool. I'm Fana Chagam Nandi. Oh, Paddy Pogodim Nandi. Name support him. Nyari Tweda, please support him, Fana. Support my boy. Please support him. Right, Mandoza. I want you to listen to this. When Mandoza brought Unkalagata, when Mandoza Lapana Ebris Unkalagata, Yapana Umlu, Umanager work. So, Umanager work won't get a studio Lapan. Right, Mandoza wa phandle. Mandoza was sitting outside. And then umlungu wakhe wafika waphesa kwezinyo kwizinto. So wathi nkalalantan, wathi dadadan, dalantantan. Yabo? Mandoza lokhu hlezi evrandini, so elokhu ebambi lokhu ze so. Ikhiwa lokhu lizidlala ama-instrumenti. Lathi dadadan, dalantantan. Yabo? Mandoza wabuya so, egijima so Mandoza. Mandoza wathi, you wanna be so nice, man, Jingoma. That's what they are. That's how Mandoza started. Lalela.
I've been there for all of us. Honorable ministers, thank you for having me today as well. I really appreciate the hand that you have in forwarding our music and bringing the people together as a nation. Nkalakata, that was something that I really think I should just say right up front, that was divine intervention. It was the Creator and the ancestors working together for all of us. We had done all the Chistok albums before then. We had already launched him as a solo artist on 925 Zola South. 925 Zola South. I can't say enough about that album. It was the start of our journey together. But the second album was already pressured, because now we have Zoitolaganja, Lele Cornel, and everybody was dancing to that. And people were saying, what are they going to do now? The pressure was on, and the record company was saying, well, now we really need a bigger one. And him and I looked at each other and thought, okay, it's not like before. It's not just writing songs anymore. You've got this big responsibility now. But to be honest with you, at the time when he came to Cape Town, Mpo was already pregnant at this stage with his first boy, to Kolo. And he arrived at, from the airport. We were really hungry. And we first, now hang on, Mendoza was always hungry. He was always hungry. It doesn't matter if he had just eaten. If you ask him, yeah, I'll have some more, thank you. So we were there at in Cape Town, looking at the beautiful mountain there, and having a nice chat and talking about what we're going to do on the next album, and the phone rang. And he didn't have a cell phone then yet. I had one of those big bricks, you know. And the phone rang and the news came through. I just saw his face light up, and that was when his first son was born. So we took him straight back to the airport. He stayed with her for about a week or whatever. He did his daddy thing, and then he came straight back to Cape Town. And we were busy playing around in my house, and I had this sound that I was working on the keyboard, and I was just playing around with this sound. He was sitting outside scribbling some lyrics, you know. And I was doing down, da 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 down, da 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 down. And he came running in. Now you know what he's like when he's excited. The last time I seen him that excited was in the car on the way to the airport when he heard his son was born. And he came and he said, "Black Gaps, that's it, brother, this is big Black Gaps, this is going to be." And I was like, "What? Okay." You know, but I didn't realize, and judging from his expression, I just realized that there was something happening here. So in that moment, I put him in the booth, and I'm telling you, it was incredible. And that's why I say definitely, you know, the creator and the ancestors must have had something to do with it, because it happened so easily, so easily.
Yeah, I'm so good, man. na machazo wembata Shoka Dalia, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Tora sindi uone magic, shino shamura jese. marula, matola marans mapula, nasi tiri kuchamula, basho da rescue, tota leluya, nekungo kaya pleasure mumetula, HKTV kupigarula, ariba pleasure isunge sudarula, tota kufara kushikana, ndi tuwa pamobeta kunge chigulani, matira buruta senda mapisa, ne moto safaya president itulani, nabinda burua yoko kipika, jimogo zopura, zuchite skubani, sachake na mobanjira, wiwane se mpenye wangu, urimu ulani. Mapula kule mzese, disapie, sapie, nilata kukwajita hepi disie, natushori disapie, sapie, mwenye kila mundu wa sirie, anakaji hepi.
How are you folks in all parts of the world today? Hope you're all fantastic. I love you so much. I love you so much. You mean a lot to me. Let me tell you something, guys. We have got so many things coming up. So many things coming up. I love you so much. Let me tell you something, guys. If you want to promote at Withinshore FM, feel free to give me a call. My name is Yaman Shal Commander. I love you so much. You mean a lot. You mean a lot. enjoy the program, honest enough. The program, guys. I love you so much. I really, really love you so much. You mean a lot to me. You mean a lot to me. Thank you so, so, so much for those who managed to listen to the program today. You are awesome. Yali Tanda Longe. I love you so much, guys. You mean a lot to me. Thank you very much. This place was boring. Yali Tanda Longe, you know what I'm going to say. Thank you very much for listening to Steve Kakana. My little boy, Orin Toby. This place is body. That's all that's recorded. Thank you. I'm